Look at Brian. Look at that geeky shirt he's wearing. Oh my God. Look at all the pockets and flaps and shit. It's so tacky. Oh my God.
Sanitizer.
That's enough. That's enough. Here we go.
Hold on. Rewind. There's more to the start of this adventure than meets the eye.
Hi, so the week before we went away, I got very sick with the flu, home the whole week from work. Then Brian got sick just before we were leaving, even worse. And in the shower, getting ready Saturday morning, phone rings. Our travel agent, Kelly, left a message for us, called her back, and she asked if we were okay. I said, I'm fine, we're
fine.
Great, everything's great.
We're ready to go.
Back and getting ready to go. And she said, you guys missed your flight. And I was just in shock, obviously. And
oops.
Bottom line is the flight was leaving 1:20 a.m. Friday night, Saturday morning. We thought it was leaving Saturday night, Sunday morning. So we missed our flight. I was in shock. I couldn't even deal with that. So I just passed the phone to Brian and said, here, you take care of it. Because he was the one that was organizing the whole flight part of our trip. He was dealing with Kelly, our travel agent, the whole time. And
so I managed to change reschedule all the departure with a little bit of coin, and so we were able to leave that night at the same time, but on the Saturday night, Sunday morning, and we shifted everything over one day. But we still had to schedule all the flights coming back, and we did that at the resort.
Yeah, with limited Wi-Fi. All we had was Wi-Fi. There was no phones, no anything. So trying to get an internet connection was sketchy at best. Finally worked out.
So we were ready to leave that day, and you were getting your nails done.
Yeah, I was just running a last minute errand.
And there was a snowstorm.
Big snowstorm, and just literally two minutes from home, and I got into a car accident. Cars totaled.
But you were okay.
I was okay, yeah. So it was kind of a strange start to this trip.
So now we can continue. Five flights and a boat ride. So here we are in Hong Kong. First leg of our trip, 15-hour flight. I didn't sleep much, watched probably about five movies. And so I don't smell too bad yet, but I'm gonna try to catch a few Z's now. And catch up with you later. Tired, fading, hoping to get some sleep on the next flight. We've arrived in Surabaya, and we're waiting for our next flight to Jakarta. And so far so good. We have all of our luggage with us, and just looking forward to these last three stops, and hopefully everything goes well. And just gonna try again to catch some shut eye. I'm delirious at this point. We just arrived in Makassar. It's about 4 in the morning, and we have one more flight to go to Sarong, and that's it, and then the boat ride. So one more flight. I've got my makeshift bed here. I've stolen a pillow from the plane and a blanket, so just trying to sleep where we can, and we're almost there, getting close.
Yeah. Lari Candida.
Bird of Paradise this morning.
Hey, there's Martin. Morning,
he's
Martin.
He's going to accompany us, and he's going to help us find our beautiful Wilson's Bird of Paradise. So it's 4 in the morning, and we're going to have tea, and then we're going to go into the boat, and we're going to go to another island and search for the Wilson's Bird of Paradise. So keeping fingers crossed. So the Wilson's Bird of Paradise is found only in the forests of two islands, Waigeo and Batanta, which are just west of the mainland of Papua New Guinea.
A little bit, yeah, just so I see the color.
Look at him.
Hello, beautiful.
Beautiful. Wasn't recording.
Beautiful. It's a millipede. Oh, hello.
A little bit, yeah. So it's not harsh. Yeah. You can bring it here. Yeah, feather the light. Yeah. Ooh.
Now it's just time to wait until the bat come.
Yeah. All the way up.
Can you go up again for a movie?
Oh, so beautiful.
Hi, Yasmin.